Welcome to Young Tuition. Let's continue discussing basic issues in climate physics in relation to what you might have heard but would like to know more in depth. In history of physics and other fields, many important discoveries were made by accident. Does that mean every accidental finding is important? Well, you could argue this answer case by case for a long time, but what you are going to watch is a completely new case. Nobody knows except myself. In short, I have just discovered by accident that the display of CO2 infrared absorption peak centered at 15 micron is incorrect. Let's go and have fun. Last week, I reported my simplified model for simulating the CO2 infrared absorption peak centered at 15 micron, in which nearly 10 representative CO2 absorption spectra previously published in the past century have been compared with some quantitative insights. This is a quantitative reproduction of the CO2 absorption spectra centered at 50 micron you can find from this official website, provided you have used the correct scale. The most important result is the simulation of the experimentally observed CO2 absorption by Dr. Hans Haag. That is very amazing. Although the peak is actually much higher than experimentally observed result, many viewers give me a round of applause, which makes me very pleased, but some viewers seem skeptical. In particular, one viewer made a detailed explanation why he was not convinced by my suggestion that the CO2 absorption peak appeared in the Nimbus 4 observation in 1970 was fabricated. Guess how I felt? I was also pleased to his remark because I love challenges from gentlemen and also from ladies, hopefully. In fact, I plan to talk about the related theoretical aspects these gentlemen kindly mentioned, such as the pressure and temperature dependent IR line broadening, which is part of my early research in the 1990s. So stay tuned. Today, I will only tell the new discovery by accident. At the beginning, I simply adjusted the relative heights of the peaks and their line width, as well as the width of the continuum profile. As you can see, the fitting has been greatly improved compared with the using the first model called CO2-15-SIN-1.0. Nevertheless, I was not satisfied about this CO2-15-SIN-2.0 at all, because such a phenomenological approach to optimizing the fitting violates the basic theory of quantum mechanics. You know, the relative spectral intensities, or the peak heights, adopted in CO2-15-SIN-1.0 were by no means arbitrary, but quantitatively based on some early theoretical calculations, namely the spontaneous transition probabilities by using the well-established perturbation method. To be exact, the ratio of the height of the central peak to the side peak is 1 to 40. Here is another reference which gave the ratio as 1 to 30, very close. So, CO2-15-SIN-2.0 is at the best a toy. That's why I decided not to report this improved simulation. I was about to do something else when I accidentally doubled the CO2 concentration, like so. To my great surprise, the height of my simulated CO2 absorption peak also doubled. Actually, this was expected, that the spectral intensity should be proportional to the number of IR absorbers, as long as the scale of the vertical axis is linear. Again, this is a part of my early research in the 1990s. The reason why I was a little bit surprised might be I had been focused on the simulated CO2 absorption peak for several years, including that reported by Van Garden and Happer, that I might have subconsciously agreed that CO2 doubling could only marginally change the CO2 profile without asking why and how. To reset my way of thinking, I simply used the natural logarithmic scale for my first model, CO2-15-SIM1.0. Guess what? The similarity is obvious between my simulation with the CO2 absorption spectra calculated by many others using high-trend database. Besides, when I invoked the CO2 doubling, the response was small, similar to others. Shall I say sigh of relief now? Not at all. This is because this new discovery by accident implies that all of the simulated CO2 absorption band centered at 15 micron might be wrong, completely inconsistent with the basic principle of IR spectroscopic measurement. To help you to understand this, let's have a look of the Planck blackbody radiation law, or the Planck function in short, both in the linear and logarithmic scales. As you can see, the Planck function looks apparently different in such different scales. Obviously, the blackbody radiation curve used as a reference to simulate CO2 absorption is linear, both horizontal and the vertical. Why? Because only by adopting such linear scales can the area or a slice of the area under the curve is proportional to the radiation flux or absorption intensity, namely watt per meter square in the system international law. Now, return to this calculated outgoing long-wave radiation that might be observed at the top of the atmosphere by looking downward at the Earth's surface. Look carefully, the blackbody reference is displaced in a linear vertical scale, but the CO2 absorption peak is, as we just discussed earlier, shown in the logarithmic scale. This is another fundamental flaw in the ICCP's CO2 narrative for the hypothetical greenhouse effect. I will make an announcement of the new breakthrough in formulating the CO2 infrared absorption in the atmosphere in light of this accidental finding soon. Thank you for your viewing. Please support my ongoing research by subscribing this channel and making comments. See you next time.